안녕하세요. 저는
Greetings. I'm Dr. Kim Jong-hoon. I'm with the Prosthodontics Department at Yonsei University Dental School. Today, I'm going to talk about digital implant impression taking process. Digital implant impression taking. Recently, we use intraoral scanners for that quite a lot. Using oral scan data means that we are scanning the oral cavity directly, so it doesn't go through the traditional impression taking. Therefore, we use the expression direct digitalization. Model scan, traditional impression taking is used, and the gypsum model from it is converted into digital data using a model scanner. After that, the data is used in a CAD software to design prosthesis. That is the process. And lastly, the designed data is sent to a lab. And finally, the result is obtained. Intraoral scanners provide color scans. As you can see, if you use an intraoral scanner, not only the form of teeth, colors of the teeth, and the colors of gum surrounding the teeth and other information can be obtained if you do intraoral scanning. With the intraoral scans, you can go to the prosthetic process and you can show and explain with the colorful information the patient's oral condition, an advantage. If you look at the right, it's a monotone model scan data. So model scan data doesn't have a full colors. So model scan data's advantage is that it can provide more precise scan data, so it can be used for a very big case or when you have to simultaneously fabricate multiple prostheses. Here, scan bodies are used to take impressions of implants. Transgingival profile is obtained. Healing abutments are connected, then they need to be removed, and this is scanned with the entire teeth. The gingival profile around the implant's place can be obtained. Second, the scan bodies are connected and further scanning is performed. Scan bodies are used to obtain information on implant locations, such as implant placement depth or direction, and information about position and direction of hex structure, which is working as anti-rotational function. Next, libraries are called in to the CAD software. Scan data is called in the CAD software. It is the position of scanning of scan bodies. So in itself doesn't have any information about implants. But if you bring in the library data from then on, we can estimate the implant positions with the data from the library. They are merged with the scan body data scanned by pointing various landmarks. They are matched and implant positions are reproduced in the CAD software. From that time on, prosthetic design can begin. The abutment is designed and also the crown. The process can be performed. Bringing in the library is very important to provide very precise prosthesis. The principle of using the library, a scan body, there are many different forms depending on the manufacturers. The key structure like this, that's the flat surface. It can control the implant position and direction. A library data is brought in, and if you mark the flat surface, The key features can be marked for merging, and you can see these are matched here, and based on this position, implant position can be estimated. That is the purpose of using the library data. Next, prosthetic design. There are many things to consider that will be explained in the design lecture. The thickness of the prosthesis needs to be considered, and the angle of an abutment, and the form of gingiva, the concave form, and things like that needs to be considered for the design. After that, milling. A milling machine is used. Milling is carving out an abutment. Zirconia or ceramic can be milled using the machine. Various materials can be milled to fabricate an abutment or crown. The scanned data, I talked about using the scan bodies for implant level impressions. You can use scan healing abutments, that is the component having very important information for scanning. Next, abutment level impression can be taken using abutments. Let me explain about it. In the case of skin bodies, as I talked about the principle of using it, there are very good and convenient tools to transfer the skin bodies. If you look at here, a skin body, when it is connected in the mouth, it is not comfortable. The skin body is very small. And when it is connected, the adjacent teeth would be interfering, so the process of connecting is rather challenging. So this carrier is used to transfer the skin body. Using the carrier, the skin bodies are connected to accurately position the hex position. So using this kind of component would be helpful. And this top part is used to tighten the screw at the bottom. So skin body hex position is determined, and the skin body screw can be accurately screwed to connect the skin body very stably and accurately. So that is the driver component for that. Scan healing abutment is to be introduced here. Here, it is not much different from a healing abutment, but if you look at here, the top part has various information in the component to estimate the implant positions. Let me go into details. Healing abutment and skin bodies, the functions of them are combined. Can you see it here? There's a feature. A special structures to estimate implant positions. There are some code contained in there. It can be used as a healing abutment, but when implant impression is taken, this can be scanned, and the special feature is used to estimate the implant position. After implant surgery, a healing abutment is connected. Sometimes this needs to be tightened and removed multiple times. A healing abutment needs to be removed to connect a skin body going back and forth, but this has the function of a skin body, so you can scan it without removing it. This may look trivial, but clinically this can reduce the chair time. This is convenient for patients and clinicians, a very important tool. So with the scan healing abutment connected, it is scanned directly. The scan healing abutment needs to be removed when final abutment and a crown need to be delivered. During surgery, there's no need to remove it, so it is removed only once during the delivery. It's a great advantage. When we use scanbody in a traditional way, healing abutment should be removed, a scanbody should be connected, and the healing abutment needs to be connected again, so the removal happens quite a lot. Abutment level impression can also be taken. You already know the traditional impression taking method after connecting an abutment. This kind of impression cap is connected. Using impression material, impression is taken. Intraoral scanning can be done after connecting an abutment. However, when intraoral scanning is done, the margin can be subgingiva, so the margin or things like that cannot be accurately taken. So library data can be used, and it is merged, and that should be used for designing. Digital impression taking, compared to analog option, it is very simple and it is saving time. And scan data remains, it is saved. So for refabrication, when something breaks, that can be used again, a great advantage. A CAD software is used, so whatever we want can be implemented easily. The biggest advantage would be using digital library. Implant components are included in the digital library and they can be virtually used like real products, a great advantage. Time saving can be achieved. It is simple. It takes 5 to 10 minutes to take impression. Impression material setting time is required, so it can be 10 minutes, and we need to wait until the gypsum model set, and sometimes we cannot obtain the model on the day, but the digital approach takes 3 to 5 minutes. As soon as scanning is finished, everything is completed. The scan data is digitalized immediately, a great advantage. Scan data is saved like this. Using it, necessary lab works can be produced repeatedly, another advantage. Using the digital CAD software, more precise design can be achieved in the way we want with the digital data between lab technician and dentists, close communications can be achieved. This is the highlight of today's lecture. A stock abutment library. Link abutment library and various libraries exist, so they can be used in fabricating the prosthesis. So that's the great advantage in taking digital impression. Another pros and cons compared to analog, which is cluttering the environment. When we take impressions and the gypsum model, materials are used and the environment can be cluttered because of that. Using a scanner, everything can be performed in a clean way. Impression materials come in contact with the gum and oral cavity, causing inflammation, and the impression material can remain in the mouth, causing inflammation. That's a disadvantage, but digital method is free from that. So it is free from inflammation. Lastly, summary, comparing analog versus digital.
차이를 이렇게 간략하게 보여주는 이미지인데요.
Using scan data by exchanging files through good communication with the lab, a dentist can check the design and others. There are many advantages, so digital impression taking has a lot of advantages. On the other hand, in an analog approach, impressions models need to be sent and received physically, which is inconvenient. That is highlighting the advantage of the digital. So we talked about digital approach. More details will be provided in the offline master course. Thank you very much for your attention.